Cozyton, a hideous sham of a town in which the prosperous citizens have no gripes or moans. Sadly, even the children are happy and secure. This is because they aren't punished for non-existent crimes.
Ah, let's do something about that then. Okay, right, so pretty much the same. It said, yeah, pretty much just do the same. So let's start by producing here and here. And do the old number two style. Line the corridors with money. Right. Oh yes, I need to hold it. Faster. Clean faster. Yeah, excellent, there we go. Money's coming in again.
Gold reserves are running low.
Wasted. They do actually become quite effective when they get, I think it's level 3, they get speed, so they can just speed themselves up, and level 10 they get teleport, so they can just instantly teleport from one location to the other. I think beetles are pretty crap, but yeah, I'm just putting them in there for variety more than anything else. So yeah, you continue to find walls, good, good, good. Now you will notice if you fortify these two walls, and that wall's not a hole or claimed by somebody else, then you will automatically fortify that as well, just because you can't otherwise get to it. Now is there any money elsewhere? Oh, there is some money elsewhere, some money out here. We'll be right back. water. Fortify this area. Just go out and just dig all around here and fortify it so nobody else can dig in, and that gold reserve is mine. But I'm doing it this way for a change. Which means I'll probably get a lower score because I won't have double as much gold. Fortified up everywhere except the training room. They turn up, they'll come through the training room. Ah, and they come from this side, they look just wonderful.
You've traveled into a new area.
Ooh, ah! This is an unclaimed treasury.
You have taken control of a new room.
That was there. I'd forgotten. How close are they to... they're almost digging in. That's fine. They'll dig into this corridor here. That's fine. Thief goes straight to the
into a new area.
Oh. Okay, I can't fortify this area, unfortunately. Forgot that you can't fortify this, but you need to just cut out the gold instead. Never mind. There's a fly doing recon. There's more heroes. Nothing important, this is where they have off.
Your creatures are attacking the enemy!
There's a dwarf. Well, it's the first time. There's two types of dwarfs you can see. Tumble dwarf, that's fine.
Your creatures are falling in battle.
Tumble dwarf actually. Tumbling and fighting. Fighter dwarf just does fighting when you're better at it. This is where the heroes came from. This is more commonly going to be seen. The Hero Gate.
Your creatures are under attack. Your creatures are attacking the enemy.
It's fine, level 3 then.
Your minions are winning a battle.
Something for later levels than this.
Your creatures are under attack.
Bigger more spirit monsters require more space.
Winning a battle. Beware, the Lord of the Land approaches.
We shall cast you back into the shadows, Keeper.
Yeah, so if you, level 10 guys take up more space in your lair than level 1 guys, basically. So here he is. There's nothing really else down here. And there's water, so I can't claim that because I don't have bridges. Otherwise, what you can do is you clean these areas and then put traps and things around the outer hero gates. Because you can't, unfortunately, as I remember, you can't actually
shut
down the
hero gates. Under attack.
That's just to show you kind of how tough trained monsters are in comparison to untrained monsters. So there we are, that's that area done.
Dark Anna. The surviving citizens have more on their plates than a demon spawn with 3 dead adventurers to munch. Not that many citizens have survived as such.